Hey, a really warm welcome to you all to SPS Carols by Candlelight. I am so excited to welcome you. If I've not met you before, my name's Phil. I lead the team here at St Paul's, and I hope you are ready for a spectacular evening. Yeah? Up in the galleries? Yeah, brilliant. We've got some great seats up there. Hey, just before we begin, especially if you're a visitor here, just to let you know, if you need the loos are straight through the double doors on your left. And a little word about phones. You are really welcome to take a sneaky photo. But we're doing carols by candlelight rather than being bathed in phone light. So please, let's be considerate content grabbers. You're really welcome to film from the back or anything like that, but please don't kind of wave a phone in front of someone else's face. I've also been asked to remind you that we've got our live stream going on, which we're really excited about, and we know a few of you are already tuned in, so welcome to you, and that'll be available on YouTube afterwards if you want to watch back what's been going on tonight. Hey, tonight is going to be largely unannounced, but do watch out for the cues to stand and sing and sit. But there's not really much else to say other than a massive, massive warm welcome again to you all. Are you ready? Yeah. Wonderful. Well, the band are just going to make their final adjustments and then watch out for the lights to change.
Here is an illustrated summary of the news. People walking in darkness have seen a great light. Of those living in a land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice when dividing the plunder. For as in the day of Meridian's defeat, you have shattered the yoke that burdens them, the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot used in battle and every garment rolled in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from this time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this.
Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God in whom I trust. Surely He will save you from the fowler's snare and from the deadly pestilence. He will cover you with His feathers, and under His wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. You will not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor the pestilence that stalks in the darkness, nor the plague that destroys at midday. 1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it will not come near you. You will only observe with your eyes and see the punishment of the wicked. If you say, "The Lord is my refuge," and you make the Most High your dwelling, no harm will overtake you, no disaster will come near your tent. For He will command His angels concerning you to guard you in all your ways. They will lift you up in their hands, so that you will not strike your foot against a stone. You will tread on the lion and the cobra. You will trample the great lion and the serpent. Because He loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call on me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Thank you. the birth of John the Baptist foretold. In the time of Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah, who belonged to the priestly division of Abijah. His wife Elizabeth was also a descendant of Aaron. Both of them were righteous in the sight of God, observing all the Lord's commands and decrees blamelessly. But they were childless because Elizabeth was not able to conceive, and they were both very old. Once when Zechariah's division was on duty, and he was serving as the priest before God, who he was chosen by lot, according to the custom of the priesthood, to go into the temple of the Lord and burn incense. And when the time for burning incense came, all the assembled worshippers were praying outside. Then an angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right side of the altar incense. When Zechariah saw him, he was startled and was gripped with fear. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah. Your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son. You are to call him John. He will be a joy and delight to you. And many people rejoice of his birth, and for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He is never to take wine or any other fermented drink, and he will be filled with the he will bring back many people of Israel to the Lord before their God. He will go on to the Lord in the spirit and power of Elijah to turn hearts of the parents to the children and the disobedient to the wisdom of the righteous, to make ready a people prepared for the Lord." Zechariah asked the angel, "How can I be sure of this? I am an old man and my wife is well along in the years." The angel said to him, "I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you and will tell you this good news. And now you will be silent and not able to speak until this day happens, because you did not believe my words, which will come true at their appointed time." Meanwhile, people were waiting for Zechariah and were wondering why he stayed so long in the temple. When he came out, he could not speak to them. They realized he had seen a vision in the temple, for he kept making signs to them but remained unable to speak. When his time of service was completed, he returned home. After this, his wife Elizabeth became pregnant, and for 5 months it remained in seclusion. "The Lord has done this for me," she said. "In these days he has shown his favor and take away my disgrace among the people."
Sigh.
month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month, for no word from God will ever fail." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her.
Thank you. Greetings. Is this thing on? Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you, Darren. Do not be afraid. I bring good news and glad tidings to thee, Darren. Is Darren here? Just wave your hand if you wave your hand if there's a Darren in. No? Anyone? This is I'm so sorry. This is St. Paul's, yes? Yeah? St. Paul's, what have I got? St. Paul's Sharm El Sheikh. Is that? No? No? Oh! Oh, baubled. I cannot believe this has happened again. I mean, let me tell you, it's chaos up there. Yeah, it's organizational hell. I mean, it's still heaven, of course, but everyone's sort of rushing around, and you know, they're like, oh, he's coming, you know, and you know, I mean, they're getting ready for something big. Yeah, they're pulling out all the stops. They've got messengers, choirs, bands. You know, I mean, Gabriel's been sent out. I'm an angel, by the way. I don't know if that was made clear, but hello, I'm an angel. Yes, this is how we dress now, I suppose. I don't know, what's the vibe here? Sort of Westlife reunion concert. Meets sort of Arctic postman. Anyway, Gabriel's been sent out. Of course he has. Have you seen that bone structure? Yeah, that is heavenly. I tell you what, I mean, all angels weren't made equal. Yeah? God decided to give me the bone structure of sort of a long baby. Anyway, what was I saying? I should stick to the script, really. Gabriel's been sent out. But, you know, it's big when Gabriel's been sent out because he's like top-tier messenger angel. Like, he'll deliver that message to you like a bowling ball. You know what I mean? But he's also gentle and sort of comforting, you know. You know, I'm so sorry for interrupting this. It looks lovely. Yeah. I should probably go, actually. It's just that I knew this would happen. You know what I mean? I said, don't, why are you sending me? I'm not a messenger angel. Yeah, I said, that's what I said. I said, I don't do messages. I said, I'm a flautist. That's my heavenly profession. I stand at the back and I play the flute. And they were like, well, we can't send anyone else because we're all busy with plan one. Oh, plan one. Plan one. It's everything anyone ever talks about these days is plan one. Plan one this, plan one that. What's plan one? That's a good question. That's a very good question. I'm glad you asked it. Well, plan one. Yeah, well, plan one is like, basically it's kind of an angel thing, really, I suppose. Why would you know? Plan one is basically... how to describe it? It's like plan one. I mean, it's like, you know, it's like God's sort of big plan, right? You know, you get told about it. You know, you get sent it in a welcome pack when you become an angel. It's you know, they send it to you in a heavenly mail. that's a heavenly email, not a heavenly mail. Although in your case, if anyway, plan one. It's like, I'll tell you what, I'll pull it up. I've got it in my inbox somewhere. Hang on, let me see what I've got here. Plan one. It's you know, it's pretty standard stuff. I can't believe we don't know it. plan one. Here it is. Yeah. I've read this before, of course. What does it say here? Though small among the clans of Judah, out of Bethlehem will come one who will be Israel's ruler. What, Bethlehem? No, that can't be right. Whose origins are from old and ancient times, a royal baby born out of King David's line. King David? It was hundreds of years ago, wasn't it? A virgin will conceive a... No. What? No. Stop it. That cannot be. Okay, I've got to be honest. I literally have to be honest. I'm an angel. I can't lie. I've never read this. This is all news to me. So, you know what? I'm gonna leave you guys to it. I'm just gonna sort of get my head around this. Thanks for having me. Oh, if anyone sees Darren, there are. I've been told to tell him there are two donkeys waiting in his front room. He's to start breeding them immediately. Not sure what that's about, but anyway. I'm going to leave now. Peace. On Earth.
Also went out from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him, and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flock at night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby in wrapped cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared, with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth to those who warm his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told to them about this child. Who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered it in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all of the things that has heard and seen, which were just as they had been told.
Thank you. called to persevere in faith. Therefore, brothers and sisters, since we have confidence to enter the most holy place by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way opened for us through the curtain, that is, his body, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us draw near to God with a sincere heart and with the full assurance that faith brings, having our hearts sprinkled to cleanse us from a guilty conscience and having our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold unswervingly to the hope we profess, for he who promised is faithful. And let us consider how we may spur one another on toward love and good deeds, not giving up meeting together as some are in the habit of doing, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching.
Of virgin will conceive a child and call him Jesus, which literally means rescuer. God saves, God with us. A star in the sky will shine above his head. A baby in swaddling clothes, a manger is his bed. A baby born in the mud and the dirt, a prince of peace, peace on earth. A child born in the here and the now, physical, tangible, touchable. Wow, God himself will walk the earth. His feet will kick up our dust. He'll eat and drink and feel and yearn, and some will doubt, some will trust. He'll be prepared in the sight of all nations, and all who look will find salvation. He'll be a light of revelation for all men, women, all creation. A second chance, a shot at redemption, and all who are weak, he will re-strengthen. And all who are lonely, he will console. And all who are lost, their paths will unfold. He'll be a hope bringer, silence breaker, restorer of our sanity. He'll smell of home, a skin on God, a wedge between hell and humanity. A roaring lamb, a gentle storm, a pure contradiction. Both God and man upon a cross, a gruesome crucifixion. But he did nothing but love and save and care and raise, return the sick their health. And just as Lazarus left the grave, physician, heal thyself. Jesus walks once again, the lion-hearted lamb. Redemption personified, rejected death. His name is power. I am. Jesus takes our hurts and wounds, gives life to these dry bones. And all who think they're unforgivable, Jesus says, come home. We all, like sheep, have gone astray. We rise and then we fall. For the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He'll open the door to eternal life. God's gift given freely. Paid in blood, the ultimate price. Who does that? No, really. God so loved the world that he gave us his, that we might live. And if that's not love, then I don't know what is. So when we're hurting and alone and the world's in disaccord, when it's darkest and it's hardest, cast your cares unto the Lord. The rude interruption to our mindless passivity. For today, to us, a child is born, a king is born, nativity.
morning, everybody. Great to be with you. If we haven't met before, my name is Philippa. I'm part of the team here at St. Paul Shadwell. You can blow your candles out now. You may have noticed this evening that our theme has been the angels. These incredible, mysterious beings, symbols of hope, who bring good news to those who least expect to hear it. Two women who find themselves pregnant, one too old and one unmarried, and some shepherds who are usually the last to know anything. The smelly, scruffy ones who have to stay out in the fields with the livestock. And the messages that the angels bring each time are messages of hope. Messages of a turning moment, a moment where those receiving the message know they'll never be the same again. And today, all of this, Christmas itself, it's all about hope. In the book of Proverbs in the Bible, it says this: hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. I wonder today, what's making your heart sick? You know, because we look around at the world, we scroll through our news feeds, we talk to our friends and our colleagues, and everywhere we look, there is just so much that makes it feel like there is no hope. And even now, as I'm speaking, I'm sure there are things that are springing to mind for you, whether it's global issues like climate disaster, war, or issues closer to home, you know, the cost of living, homelessness, desperate family situations. There is a lot in the world that can make our hearts sick. And each of us, we look around searching for hope. You know, the Bible is actually a collection of stories of people or groups of people seeking hope. And the reassuring thing about it, in one way, is that the whole spectrum of people can be found in the pages of the Bible. Kings, pharaohs, and royalty, sick people, dying people, unclean people, the mentally unwell, the homeless, widows, orphans, business owners, tax collectors, mums, dads, and children, all searching for hope. Searching for something or someone who's going to show them that everything really will be okay. And you know, the Bible is also full of people putting their hope in the wrong thing, things that make their hearts sick. And again, the whole spectrum is there. Magic and idols, unhealthy relationships, money, sex, a whole collection of people who have deferred their hope and their hearts are sick. Hope deferred makes the heart sick, but a longing fulfilled is a tree of life. I wonder what it is making your heart sick today. Where have you been putting your hope? Is it causing trees of life to spring up in your life? I want to suggest today that there is a hope that can be found, which is an absolute certainty. It's a dead cert. The reason that we are gathered to celebrate in such a way like this, the reason we go over the top with music and lighting and decorations and get so excited when we gather like this, is not because it's Christmas and that's what we do. It's because we, each of us, are desperate for you to know that the hope we have in this God, the kind of God who would choose to come to earth as a tiny, vulnerable baby, the kind of God who would live a perfect life amongst us, who would seek out those who are on the margins of society and give them hope. This hope is a hope that is guaranteed. This God who would choose not only to be born in a shed amongst livestock, but would choose to die by murder, being nailed to the cross, all so that each of us could have access to hope. Not one-off, flash-in-the-pan hope, but real life, everyday, mind-blowing hope. is the reason we do this. It's the reason we celebrate this day and every Christmas and every day. So what is our response to be? Well, when the angels visited and Elizabeth found out that she would be pregnant at her advanced age, her response was, "The Lord has done this for me." When the angels visited Mary and she found out she'd become pregnant with Jesus, the Messiah, the one coming to bring hope, her response was, "I'm your servant. May your word to me be fulfilled." And when the shepherds were visited by the angels and told that a Savior had been born to them, their response was, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So I wonder what your response to this incredible hope is today. Maybe in this moment you're realizing for the first time, like Elizabeth, the Lord has done this for me. Maybe it's never clicked into place for you before. And this is the moment you want to accept hope, that real hope, which is 100% certain, which will not make your heart sick. And if that is the case, I wonder if the response for you should be the same as Mary's. Lord, may the word that you have spoken to me be fulfilled. You know, in fact, for each of us, whether we're followers of Jesus or not there yet, we have a choice about who or what we put our hope in. Not just now, but daily, hourly sometimes. And wherever we find ourselves this Christmas, whether our hearts are sick or whether we're full of joy from the hope that Jesus has brought, let's each of us, along with the shepherds, call one another. Let's go to Bethlehem and see what has happened. Let's see what the Lord has done. That thing that the Lord has told us about, let's go see it. Let's go see that God himself is the kind of God who chose to come to earth as a baby to give us real life hope at Christmas and always. Let me finish with some very famous words from Isaiah chapter 40. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. But he gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Amen.
Amen. lest we all get too serious, take ourselves a little bit too seriously, we're going to have a bit of fun with the 12 Days of Christmas. We're going to sing this together. It's not a carol per se, but it was a goodie. So we're going to sing it. Now, this is a bit of an audience participation situation. So there's a few actions, and you're all very much welcome to do them, encouraged. Can you wave at me if you have a January birthday? Okay, if you have a January birthday, you're responsible for the first day of Christmas, a partridge in a pear tree. So can you do a partridge in a pear tree for me? This is the pear. You're all January, that row? Fantastic. Lovely. Okay, if you are a February birthday, where are you? February, you're responsible for, what is it? Partridge in a pear tree. This one, turtle doves. Two turtle doves. So give me a turtle dove. Good. The third one is, I need the words up there, French hens. This one, March birthdays, lovely. April, four calling birds. That's less of an embarrassing one. So if you're an April birthday, May, five, you have five golden rings, my favorite, like this. Okay, that's you. And six geese are laying, where are you, June? That's six geese are laying. You have to stand up, obviously. I didn't say that. When you do your thing, you have to stand up. Five golden rings, six. Oh, no, hang on. Seven. Six geese are laying. Seven swans are swimming. What's that? September? July. August. Maids are milking. September. Ladies dancing. Make these your own. Ten is... Lords are leaping. Just give me a little leap. Or whatever you can manage. 11, Piper's piping. And 12, that's me, December birthday. 12, what is it? Drummer's drumming. Lovely. So when it gets to your one, January, you're going to have a lot of standing up to do. You're going to stand up, do your action with effort and energy and aplomb. And then it will be fun. Are you ready for it? Let's go, band. So we'll see. Let's see how this goes. We need to match that enthusiasm with the rest of the things. So let's do three on the third day of Christmas, March. Get ready. Here we go. Ready? One, two, three. On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three French hens, two turtle doves. Oh, very good. On the fourth. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me
fantastic. What an incredible evening. Wow. Wow, what an amazing carols by Candlelight. I hope that you have been inspired and filled with hope. But before I say anything else, can we just say a massive thank you for the band and for the choir, for Leanne, who's been leading us, for all of the volunteers, for everyone that's spoken and read. And can we give a huge thank you to Matt Benville? Matt has masterminded this whole evening. Come on, let's hear it again. Well done. Fantastic. What an incredible evening. That was amazing. I feel quite emotional. I've absolutely loved every single moment. Hey, the only real thing that I want to add is just to say, if there's anything that has kind of really inspired you tonight, maybe for the first time, we would love to continue that conversation with you. We get to celebrate incredible things in Advent and at Christmas, but as people that believe and know and love Jesus, we get to do that actually every single day of every single week. And we would love to talk to you more about that. If you want to find out any more about church or about Jesus, the stuff that Philippa was talking to us about a little bit earlier, do grab one of the people in a lanyard, one of the hosts at the end. They'd love to talk to you a bit more about what goes on here at St. Paul Shadwell. And you can always head to our website, sps.church, and find out a little bit more about who we are. And finally, we would love to invite you to come to Alpha in the new year. There are some of these flyers at the back, and you might get handed one on the way out. And Alpha really is an amazing way to go on discovering more and exploring the meaning of life and faith and everything. And we're going to be starting a new Alpha course in the new year, and we would love it if you would come and join with us. Hey, in a moment, I'm going to ask us to stand for our final carol, and then you'll be glad to know there's plenty of mulled wine and mince pies. So before we stand, in fact, the last thing for me to do is to pray a blessing for us all. So would you receive this? Go in peace. May the wisdom of the wonderful counselor guide you. May the strength of the mighty God defend you. The love of the everlasting Father enfold you, and the Prince of Peace be upon you. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may it be upon you, and may it remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Would you please stand?
Joyful and triumphant. wind like it did.